These men are perhaps the future of Greece. Evstratios Kahaias and Leontios Stampolidis are electrical engineers in their early 30s, and they own a business. We meet up with them in a district of the nation's capital, Athens, where something has developed that you might not expect in Greece. An internationally successful high-tech cluster. 80 companies and 40 universities from across the country have built up a network here. With their startup, the two entrepreneurs are among the youngest members.
The most important thing is that you should not get obsessed with crisis, because people get obsessed and say the crisis. Okay, so the crisis is here, so what? So we work hard. We work hard and we believe in what we're doing. This is the very basic thing. Just.
The two former students have developed special amplifiers for fiber optic cables, which are used by telecommunications and internet companies to transfer data. The entrepreneurs are not discouraged by the fact that they're just a small startup in a country suffering an economic crisis.
Customers are very much interested in what we do because we are a small company and we can develop custom products exactly tailored for them. This type of activity is something that you don't get from very large companies.
Another company in the same building, Hellic, is proof that Greek IT companies can enjoy international success. Hellic has clients around the world.
We have actually no customers in Greece at all. All our clients are mainly in the United States, West Coast, California, Arizona, Oregon, Texas, and then on the east side of the US.
Hellic also sells to clients in Japan and China, and Germany's Infineon also has its chips programmed by the company. Its CEO and founder thinks Greece has a real future in the IT industry. The country has plenty of well-educated people, and success in IT depends more on innovation and creativity than on having a lot of capital.
The fact that a country of 11 million people doesn't have enough, let's say, size as a market should encourage all businesses, all entrepreneurs, to look outside the country and try to find markets and opportunities outside.
Yorgos Koutsoyanopoulos says it's very beneficial for a small company like his, dealing on major markets, to be based in the Eurozone. The Euro has given Hellic a boost. It's had rather less support from Greek politicians.
We are in the middle of a kind of a revolution. Peaceful, of course, but it's kind of a revolution. So I'm not able, you know, to predict in the short term what the outcome would be. Definitely, I'm by nature, I'm optimistic, so I believe that the Greeks will find their way out in concert with the rest of Europe, because we strongly believe that our destiny and our future is inside this European family.
The startup duo also hope Greece stays in the Eurozone. They've filed for patents for the products they've developed. And they're now looking for investors so they can start production and marketing.
The question for us is not what we expect from the politicians or from the state or from the society, but rather what the state and the society expects from us now. So now it is time for us to offer something to the society.
One thing they can offer is jobs with a future. And maybe they can do their bit to help restore Greece's self-confidence.